Christmas is almost here, but not everyone's in the spirit. It turns out the PC cops want to use the holiday to propagandize your children. Here were some appalling examples. National Review reporter Katherine Timpf. Katherine, we're always glad to have you here.
Thanks.
So if you had to list the most politically correct toys of this Christmas season, we've all buckled our seatbelts, we're ready for it. Let us know what they are.
Well, cookies, too, need to be politically correct,
cookies?
Apparently. Yes, gingerbread men are sexist. There's a bakery in Australia selling genderless, organic, vegan Christmas cookies, gingerbread figures, because gingerbread men's sexist. And you think, do we really need this? But if you look online, gingerbread sexist, gingerbread men sexist, a lot of things come up of actual adults using their adult time to get upset about a cookie.
I bet genderless gingerbread people have no taste at all.
Yeah, I bet you they don't know that, you know, they're cookies. They don't have a gender because they're cookies.
No
cookies really do.
So there's a new Barbie, a new more realistic Barbie with acne and scars and bad tattoos she regrets or whatever. This is like a supposed to be more realistic Barbie.
Well, she's more realistic in terms of her body, but actually the zits and the moles and the freckles come as a separate optional sticker pack. And a lot of feminist internet's upset by that because they're saying, oh, are you saying zits are optional and freckles are? No, just not every little girl in the world wants to sit around and put zits on her toys, and I think that's totally fine.
You know, the internet's a scary and sad place.
Yes.
Green army men, those little made in Taiwan things that, you know, you get.
Right. One of the most normal Christmas toys ever. Apparently, they project the idea that men are supposed to be aggressive and violent, and there's actually people out there saying that they lead to domestic violence because of this, which is insulting to the military and insulting to the intelligence of any young man who might be interested in playing with
this. So how is the military supposed to keep ISIS from coming to Milwaukee?
I don't know. Apparently, there's no way it's possible because army men are too offensive.
It's unbelievable. Now, genderless, because gender itself is a construct. It's not real, as you may have noticed.
Right.
It's totally made up. It's not based in biology at all. It's just based in consumer culture. There are lots of genderless books out there.
Yes,
for
yes. There's a whole series of genderless princesses who are also environmentalists. There's a new one, Princess 1010, who is also kind of fights against the horrors of fossil fuel dependent economies, which I don't think people are talking about in the playground when they're 6 years old. I don't think it's really going to appeal to any kids.
I wish that all propaganda in kids' books was this obvious. This is obviously just Stalinist crap, and you would never, no normal person would buy this for his kids.
Right.
But I can say I have a house full of children's books. A lot of them have this stuff in them. They're all pushing some kind of creepy agenda on your kids.
Right. And I also kind of hate the idea that people actually think kids are going to be that influenced by a fairy princess. Young girls are going to say, oh, I need to look like this, or I need to live in a castle. Princesses aren't realistic. Nobody thinks fairy princesses are a realistic career choice as a child.
You know,
I think
who
it's really
never did this to children? Richard Scarry. Mr. Busy Town.
I was a big fan.
Richard Scarry is a total hero in the world of children's books.
All right,
he's
more
dead,
Richard
unfortunately.
Scarry.
I'd love to have him on.
More Richard Scarry.
Kat Timpf from National Review.
Yes.
We're glad to have you as
great
always.
Great to see you.
Thanks.